The following is a reading of The Crayon Man by Natascha Biebow and illustrated by Steven Salerno, as read by the fourth grade class at Pemetic Elementary School, right here in Southwest Harbor, Maine.
Once there was a man who saw color everywhere. He noticed the yellow-orange petals of the black-eyed Susans in the garden. He marveled at the rich red-scarlet tones of the cardinal's feathers. He admired the deep blue greens of the waves in the sea. Color made him really, really happy.
But all day long at work, all he saw was black. Black dust, black tar, black smoke, black ink, black dye, black shoe polish.
His company sold carbon black, a new kind of pigment or colored substance made from the soot of burning oil and natural gas. People used it in printing inks, electric street lamps, and stove and shoe polish. It also made rubber car tires last much longer.
His name was Edwin Viney, and he was an inventor. He worked with his cousin C. Harold Smith. Together, they were Viney and Smith. Harold was a great salesman. He loved to travel the world. Edwin was curious. He had a knack for listening and making what people needed.
Edwin invented a new kind of inexpensive slate pencil that wrote very smoothly. It was gray. Children loved it. He invented a kind of chalk that wasn't dusty and didn't crumble. It was white. Teachers loved it. He invented a wax crayon that would write on wood and paper packaging. It was really, really black. People loved it.
Paper was expensive in the 1800s, so children wrote with slate pencils or chalk on slates, small handheld blackboards.
Everyone, including Edwin's wife, Alice, told him that children needed better, cheaper crayons. He listened. They said, "The crayons we have are really big, dull, and clumsy. The lumps of colored clay only make fat, chunky lines, and the artist's crayons from Europe are too expensive. They crumble and break easily, and some are even poisonous."
Edwin thought about his company's inventions. When you drew a picture with a gray, stale pencil, it rubbed off at the drop of a hat. When you drew a picture with a white chalk, it smudged everywhere. If you drew a picture of Edwin's new really black crayon, it was, well, really black. None of his inventions was any good for drawing in color.
So Edwin listened, and Edwin invited in a small stone mill in Pennsylvania in a top secret lab. Edwin's team experimented in how could they make better, stronger crayons, melted pavilion wax, perhaps.
First color crayons invented in Europe were made from a mixture of charcoal and oil, so they broke easily. To make stronger crayons, Edwin tried using wax instead.
Now for the crayon colors, grinding up rocks and minerals into fine powders. Mix, slate for gray, earth for yellow, red and brown, perhaps. Oh, yes, and lapis for blue. Pounding, shifting, and heating the colored powders, would they be bright enough? Edwin's team kept on trying. They kept on experimenting.
Ground up rocks and minerals made bright pigments for crayons. Red iron oxide, hematite for red, yellow iron oxide, goethite for yellow, varied shades of red iron oxide for brown, carbon black for black, zinc oxide for white, and imported ultramarine made from lapis lazuli for blue.
They came home covered in color.
They experimented some more and discovered a pinch of this pigment, a sploosh of that one, a little hotter, a little colder, and voila, lots of different shades. Now they were greens, orange, and violets, and pinks too. Edwin came home covered in color.
To make orange, green, and violet, chemists blended various pigments and clays. Some minerals changed color when heated. Plus, the length of time the mixtures were left to cool created different colors, too.
A large tub at the mill, Edwin's team measured out the ingredients. Melted wax, clay to thicken, something for texture, colored powders. Each in just the right amount every time to make a top-secret formula. Slowly, carefully, stirring by hand, they poured the special formula into the crayon-shaped molds. Smaller than any other inventor's, just the right size for children's hands. The mixture cooled and hardened. Edwin watched and Edwin waited.
Children might eat or chew the crayons and get sick, so Edwin's team experimented to find new, safe, non-toxic colors and materials.
Finally, one summer evening in June 1903, Edwin came home covered in color and announced that he'd invented a new kind of colored crayon. But what should he call it? Alice had an idea. Let's mix the French word cray for a stick of chalk and the word ola from the word oleaginous, meaning oily, like the oily texture of a wax crayon, to invent a new word. Crayola, Edwin listened.
Binney and Smith shipped out the first Crayola crayon boxes, red, orange, yellow, green, blue, violet, brown, and black, 8 colored crayons for only a nickel. Edwin, wait, would children like them?
Children did. Now they could draw a tiny green caterpillar or the big blue sky. Their drawings couldn't smudge and they wouldn't rub out. They were bright and could last a long, long time.
By the 1900s, inventors had figured out how to make cheaper paper from wood pulp, so children could now draw on paper instead of just slate.
Excitement over the new colorful invention spread like wildfire, and miners from far and wide flocked to marvel at Binney and Smith's invention at the St. Louis World Fair. The company's dustless chalk even won a gold medal. Proudly, Edwin and Harold showed it off, especially on their new Crayola crayon boxes.
Every day, Edwin brought colorful bouquets from his garden to inspire the Crayola team. They made crayons in even more different shades, and later asked children to help name some of them.
To celebrate their 19th anniversary, Crayola held a color naming competition. The 6-year-old winner coined Tropical Rainforest. Other color names created by children included Robin's Egg Blue, Tickle Me Pink, and Macaroni and Cheese.
At last, because of Edwin Binney, the man who saw color everywhere, who had a knack for listening and making what people needed, children all around the world reach for just the right shade of sun glow, wisteria, jungle green, screaming green, razzmatazz, robin egg blue, wild watermelon, marvelous, purple mountain majesty, cadet blue, lavender, timberwolf, to draw anything.